How do you feel to be part of such a big tournament at this stage, as it's celebrating its 25th year?
Well, certainly this is South Asia's biggest event, and we are proud that we are able to retain this tournament in India, which will help the Indian players. And 25 years almost, and this year is being very special as Leander is playing his last event in this tour event. So certainly, yes, we are very happy to have this event in the state of Maharashtra.
Indian players playing in such a big tournament like an ATP Tour in India.
Certainly, it has so far beneficial for the Indian players, because as you see this draw, we almost have 12 Indian players playing in the main draw, mixed up, doubles and singles. Last year's we have Rohan and Devij won this event, and this year we are hoping that one of the Indians will make a history by winning the singles title. When we have a singles title from Indian, that will be the greatest achievement from our side, that you know, because of this we could get an Indian tour event champion from Pune.
What are the objectives of doing this tournament?
Well, the main objective of this, getting this tournament here, to make the awareness of tennis in the state of Maharashtra, India, as well as because just this is one of the objective, but the overall picture, we decided to take this tournament and also make a structure to go to the grassroots and increase the footfall of tennis players in the state of Maharashtra from the district. So now, as a part of this ATP event, we have started an academy, high performance academy in Pune. Then we have regional centers in district places where we'll be having coaching schemes, and then the talent will be brought here to Pune, and they will be given a residential facility with tennis coaching. So the more of the broader objective is within next 5 years, probably the footfall should increase 5 to 10 times in the state of Maharashtra, so that at the end we should be able to aim top 100 players from India.
As of now, we're not having any Indian in the top 100. Do you see any particular reason behind it?
Well, it's a very big and serious question, I think, which the AITA should have answer for this, because there must be various reasons. But what is in our hand is like to, you know, give the platform for the Indian players to get into 100, top 100 players, give the platform for the coaching facilities, you know. So, and I'm sure AITA must be thinking about this, a larger goal on how to get more and more Indian top 100 players in India, in the world. So probably we all have to come together and, you know, come to a conclusion that what exactly needs to be done. We need to involve the past players, the associations, the sponsors, you know, the government, and then make a broader vision about how to make top 100 players in coming years.
Can you tell us about the new things that we are bringing into this third edition of the Tata Maharashtra?
Well, the third edition, we have the complete LED backdrops, then we also have the side backdrop. We have the short clock this year we have introduced. We have these are the main highlighted for this year as compared to the last year.
Over the years, what all the challenges did you face to keep the show going?
We are really lucky enough to have the strong support from the government of Maharashtra, and also from the Tatas. They have committed to do this title sponsor for this event, and also the government of Maharashtra. So we really hardly have any challenges to conduct this event. The only challenge what we are facing right now is to because of the ATP Cup coming in between, the date change, and for which we have been able struggling to get you know, top 20 participations. But probably otherwise we are okay. We are selling smoothly with last 3 years.
What are your views about the emerging tennis enthusiasts in Pune?
Well, as you know that Pune is being known for capital of tennis, and we have a lot of tournament happens in Pune. We have challengers happening, we have WTA happenings, and we have a lot of rich history from Pune. We have players from past players, from right from Sashi Menons to Nandan Bal to Kirtanes. So Pune is definitely have tremendous fan following for the tennis. And as you said, as you must have seen that last 2 years, the semi-final, finals, even quarter-finals, they completely sold off. So there's a huge support from the players, from the spectators for Pune.
Okay, what are your expectations from this year's tournament?
As I said, this year's winner should be from India. And that will be really a great thing for Indian tennis. A new era will start, and we really hope for the same. That's the main.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Prashant. It was great interacting with you to understand about how the tournament is going and the new things about it. So I wish all the best to you for the tournament going forward.
Thank you very much, and I appeal to all the tennis lovers to come and see numbers and give support to our Indian tennis players, and make this event more and more richer. Thank you.